Hi, I'm Murphy Griffin.
I'm Madison Taylor.
And welcome to episode 2 of Neophyte Boat Rides.
This episode's going to have two parts. First part's going to be an introduction to lofting.
And in the second part, we're going to show you how to build a lofting stage like what we have here. So, let's get to it. So one of the unfortunate truths about traditional boat building is that arguably the most technical part of the process comes at the very beginning, and that's called lofting. Lofting has surely dissuaded many a novice boat builder from even starting building a boat, and has certainly caused many a novice boat builder to throw in the towel prematurely because they were just at wit's end because they couldn't make the lofting work out. While lofting is hard to learn, it's even tougher to teach. And that's one of the reasons why there's not a lot of good educational video content out there on lofting. But despite that fact, we're gonna give it our best shot. In this episode, we're gonna deal with lofting in broad strokes. We would like you to walk away with just a general idea of what lofting is, why it's useful, and why it's difficult in the first place. So what is lofting? Well, lofting in concept is rather simple. You're taking a boat's plans, which are drawn in a small, manageable format, and you're blowing them up life-sized. The process of taking those boat's plans and drawing them to full scale is called lofting. Now, while lofting can sound rather simple, it's really not that simple. One, there are lots of opportunities to introduce error as you move from the small scale drawing to the full scale lofting. Secondly, it's just complicated. There are lines going everywhere and it can be really hard to conceptualize what you're looking at and what it represents. And lastly, much like everything else in boat building, it's chock-a-block with weird foreign lingo that you're just gonna have to learn to deal with. So let's deal with our first lesson in boat building terminology. Why the heck is it called lofting? Well, in boat shops of yore, they wouldn't have had very much floor space to spare for the lofting. They would have had multiple boats being built all at once, one boat being planked over here, another boat being framed over there, and floor space would have been wanting. So they did what they had to do. They built a mezzanine in the boat shop, or a loft. This provided a wide expanse of flat level ground for a loftsman to go draw the boat plans to full scale. Now, this became such a fixture in boat shops that they started using the word loft as a verb. So, I can loft, you can loft, and we go loft the lofting. A little confusing, right? But I digress. Okay, so here's a general outline of the lofting process and how it can be used to determine the shape and size of different pieces of the boat. So what you start with is what's called a lines drawing and a table of offsets. Now these are representations of the same information, except one is pictorial and one is quantitative. If you look at a lines drawing, you'll see that it's a complex arrangement of curving lines, all of which are intersecting each other at different places. The table of offsets indicates where those intersections take place. So what a loftsman will do is take the table of offsets and plot those individual points on a lofting board. He or she will then connect those points with curving lines. Once the lines are correct, they can then trace out different pieces of the boat and make templates. Those templates are then taken to a piece of lumber, traced out on the piece of lumber, and cut out. So for instance, this is a template that we made of the stem of the Newfoundland trap skiff. This is a structural member of the boat that forms the very front bow of the Newfoundland trap skiff. So what we'll do is we'll take this to a piece of lumber and trace out this shape onto the lumber. Once it's traced out, we'll then cut that shape out of the lumber, clean it up, and that will actually constitute the stem of the Newfoundland trap skiff. This process is then repeated for several different pieces of the boat, specifically the transom, if the boat has a transom, like in the case of the Newfoundland trap skiff, the keel, and then most importantly, what are called the molds. The molds are sort of temporary ribs that are placed at equal distances along the keel that help the boat builder make the shape of the boat. So you can see that lofting is integral to making all these templates. Templates for the keel, templates for the stem, templates for the transom, and the molds, which help the boat builder make the shape of the boat.
So in order to show you guys how a shipbuilder might actually take information from the lofting board and translate that into an actual physical boat piece, we wanted to show you a clip from the 1940s documentary, The Shipbuilders of Essex. In it, you can actually see a loftsman making a template.
In this 1947 documentary film, The Shipbuilders of Essex, you see a loftsman going about his standard routine. He consults boat plans and a half model of the boat that the boatyard is currently working on. After consulting his plans, he returns to the lofting floor, where he set up a special jig that allow him to trace out a template of a particular part of the boat that he's working on. After tracing out the template, he'll take the template to the lumberyard, where he'll look for a special piece of lumber whose curvature best suits that part of the boat that he's currently working on. After identifying a suitable piece of lumber, he'll pass it to the yardmen, who will then take it to the bandsaw and cut it out to shape. Lofting generally begins with reference to what's called a table of offsets. This is essentially a set of coordinate points that correspond to specific locations on the hull of a boat. We've written a simplified version of a table of offsets just for demonstration purposes. This consists of two lines and four stations. In order to plot the points provided in the table of offsets, an appropriate grid has to be drawn on the lofting board. The spacing of the grid lines varies from boat to boat, depending on scale and design, but the grid almost universally consists of a network of evenly spaced vertical and horizontal lines, even sometimes diagonal lines, all with a specific relationship to one another. In this simple example, the table of offsets specifies the distance to be measured off of the baseline. The ruler is aligned with the indicated station and the measurement marked on the line. As you can see, the measurements are given as a triplet of numbers. The first number indicates how many feet are to be measured, the second number how many inches, and the third number how many eighths of an inch. This is a traditional and conventional way of presenting measurements for lofting. Once the points are plotted on the lofting board, nails are driven into the board directly next to the plotted points. A thin strip of wood called a batten is then bent around the nails and held in place with weights or additional nails. The batten connects the plotted points together with a nice smooth curve that is then traced onto the lofting board. This process is then repeated for all additional lines. A few things to bear in mind. What we have shown you is a vast oversimplification of the lofting process, and we are going to spend a lot more time on this in future episodes. So don't be fooled. In its entirety, lofting is a quite tedious and painstaking process, but taking the time to get the lofting right pays big dividends. It is conceivable that if you don't take care during the lofting process, that you could end up trying to build an unbuildable boat. So, lofter beware. So if lofting is so difficult, tedious, and generally just a pain in the butt, then why would anyone do it? Well, lofting is absolutely necessary. Think about it. 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 What you're doing in a lofting is you're taking a boat's plans and you're drawing them to full scale. With that full scale drawing, a boat builder can then trace out important parts of the boat and make templates that they can use to make those parts of the boat. Secondly, and sort of more importantly, lofting enables a boat builder to think through the boat building process in a theoretical way before they cut into any of the wood, which can be really, really useful considering how expensive some of these hardwoods are that we use in boat building. And lastly, lofting enables a boat builder or a boat designer to figure out what errors are inherent in the boat plans that they're developing or that they have purchased or acquired in whatever way. While one would hope that boat plans are gospel and without error, that simply isn't the case. So lofting gives us a way to figure out where those errors may be and root them out.
So we've established what lofting is and how it's useful. Lofting is when you take the boat plans and draw them to full scale. It's useful because it actually helps us make templates for different parts of the boat. But in order to draw them full scale, you need a suitably large canvas. Enter the lofting board. Now there's many different approaches to building a lofting board. We've decided to build what we're calling a lofting stage. We're going to build a framework of 2x4s, sheathe it in plywood, and paint it white. So let's build a lofting stage.
So what we're looking at here is how flat is the lofting stage lengthwise. We're especially interested in what's happening at the junction between the two 2x4s here. There's more than likely going to be some error where they join together. Now as you can see, there's a rather sizable gap between the lofting stage and the straight edge. Now that's not good enough for what our purposes are, but it's easily corrected. Because by design, the lofting stage has some play in it,
at the junctions here. So if I drive a shim underneath, and then run the light underneath it, you can see that that gap has diminished significantly. There's still a little bit of a gap there, but not enough to cause any concern. What we're trying to do is check the flatness long ways and check the flatness relative to the four lengths going down the lofting stage. So in order to check them against one another, we're taking the level and we're getting down real low so that we can see the if there's any space between the level and the 2x4. And since it should be touching, ideally, all four, we should see very little or no space. So as we track across, we're seeing if there are any incongruities between the four. You can see that this one's a little low, but not enough to cause any concern. It's maybe an eighth of an inch, which is an error that we can live with. And so tracking across all four, we're seeing a pretty good relationship in terms of their relative heights.
Ha ha, this a way, ha ha, that a way, ha ha, this a win, they know spin. When I was a little boy, little boy, little boy, when I was a little boy, 12 years old. Papa went and left me, left me, left me. Papa went and left me, so I was told. Ha ha, this a way, ha ha, that a way, ha ha, this a win, they know spin. Mama come and got me, she got me, got me. Mama come and got me to save my soul. Mama never whooped me, whooped me, whooped me. Mama never whooped me, so I was told. Ha ha, this a way, ha ha, that a way. Ha ha, this a win, then, oh then. I went to school, went to school, went to school, boy. I went to school when I was 12 years old. I obeyed the rules, that rules, but obeyed the rules as I was told. Ha ha, this way, ha ha, that way, ha ha, this way, and then, oh then. I went to a teacher, 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 went to a teacher to save my soul. Teacher was a preacher, 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 teacher was a preacher, so I was told. Ha ha, this way, ha ha, that way, ha ha, this way, and then, oh then. Like my lesson, 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 like my lesson to save my soul. Wasn't that a blessing, blessing, blessing? Wasn't that a blessing? So I was told, ha ha, this way, ha ha, that way, ha ha, this way, and then, oh then.
So I hope you guys understand a little bit more about lofting.
If you have any further questions, we are going to be covering this in more detail in future episodes, or don't hesitate to leave us questions in the comments or shoot us an email.
Don't forget to like and subscribe and consider becoming a patron. There's a link to our Patreon page in the description below. It really helps keep the project going and enables us to keep bringing you great content.
So stay tuned for episode 3, where we're going to be paying a visit to a big plywood barge in the mountains of Virginia. Thank you.